Before you even begin with your portfolio, you need to understand in what file format you have to save your portfolio and in what digital platform you have to upload your portfolio. And this video is exactly about that. So let's jump into it. So there are two versions of uploading a digital portfolio. One is by saving as a PDF file or a PPSX file. And the other option is uploading it online. A PDF file can be created by Illustrator, Photoshop, or even PowerPoint. You can save it as a file format and this will not be destroyed or cannot be edited by anybody. The other advantage of having PDF file is it opens in any computer or even on the phone, even if you share it as on WhatsApp or Telegram or anywhere. The second option is about saving as .ppsx, which happens on PowerPoint, Keynote, or Google Slides. And I'm sure there are other formats as well. I mean, there are other platforms as well, but these are the ones that I would recommend. Once you finish creating your portfolio on a PowerPoint or a Keynote, and you've added animations, or there is more interaction effects or transitions, and you save it as a PPSX file, boom, you get that effect. And the viewers will also be able to have that entire experience of an interactive kind of a presentation. So the advantage of sharing a PDF or a PPSX file as a file attachment on an email is there are times when you have some sensitive topics or content which is supposed to be private, but it is only for a specific need and for a specific receiver. So those can be shared as a PDF or a PPSX file. The advantage of uploading your portfolio online is it is now present in front of the world. Anybody can see it. Even when you're sleeping, somebody else from the other side of the world is actually going through it. You may get surprise calls of some work, employment, or any opportunity because of your work that you've uploaded. And at the same time, you can create a network out of it. So freaking humid, huh? But let's just do it. Let's just go on. Okay. Okay, so there are different types of experience that you can provide when you upload your work online. You have to make that choice, and before that you should explore is either you want to show it in a website way, which is very interactive and it feels more like a website experience. The other is if you want to show it more like a digital magazine or a journal kind of an experience where you have flipping pages. The third one is about uploading it right on a digital portfolio platform like Behance. Or the fourth one where you actually can work and create your own video. I mean, that's the best thing I would say. So when we talk about creating an experience like on a website, if you want to upload your portfolio and create it more like a website kind of experience, Wix.com is the best option. And there is another option which is more like a paid subscription, and that is Squarespace. These two are some great platforms where you can actually create your website kind of an experience. The advantage of this is you're actually adding on some more efforts and you're showing in an experience to your viewer, which is very important. Design, creativity is all about creating experience. And when you create a website, you actually even showcase indirectly your skills about photography, videography, layout, your taste, the entire identity of yourself, and a lot of creative other aspects, which you will realize as you start putting in stuff there. The second option is about creating more like a journal, more like a digital magazine, which can happen on issue.com. You just need to create a PDF file digitally and upload it, and it'll create its own fabulous book kind of a experience. This is perfect for people who want to get into editorials and publishing houses. Try that out. It's going to be amazing. The next option is about uploading your work on a social platform, more like a portfolio platform like Behance.net. You know, there are millions and millions of portfolios already there online. And you can also upload there because there can be interactions, there can be collaborations that can happen. And now the fourth one, which is the most important and the best option, is creating your own video. Creating your own video resume, putting up your online portfolio onto it, creating a video out of it. It just should be not more than 3 minutes. You introduce a little bit about yourself, make it very creative, make it very engaging. And at the same time, now you can slide in your portfolio pages. You can show in some videos of your design development. You can show in some of your processes and show the best of everything you can. Here, you're not limited to anything because you're also narrating your project, create a video portfolio. That's the best thing. You will not even have to present your portfolio every time there's an interview. You can always just send in a link and it works well for you. So I hope you learned a lot in this video, and I'm sure I would have missed out some other options as well. I would love it if you know something and you want to share it. That'll be a great value asset here. And if you like this video and if you're feeling you're benefiting something out of it, do subscribe to my channel and definitely share it with your friends if you feel they're going to benefit out from this video as well. And if you haven't watched my previous video about trend research, it is right here.